I'm a crybaby, so you shouldn't ask me stuff like that. I don't know. This reality hasn't set in that he has to go to jail. He shouldn't have to go to jail. He's like such a strong person, and it's weird because he's sitting there doing videos, and like I found myself emailing him the other day about something that I wanted him to do for me, and I was like, when I just thought about it, I was like, that's so selfish, because it's like, what is the mind frame of somebody that's about to go to jail for months and that has never served that amount of time in jail, you know? I'm always amazed at Wayne's dignity. Like, everything he does it with dignity. Like, you can't make him, no matter what you throw at him, you can't take away, like, his confidence, and something about him is always like, I am still who I am. You know what I mean? And I think that's just dope. Like, this dude is, you know, he's a legend.
Yeah. Did your grandmother ever get to see you perform? Do you think your grandmother would be proud of you right now? Of the woman you became?
When you're from the islands, your parents will leave and then send for you because it's easier when they've established themselves, when they have a place to stay, when they have a job. I thought it was going to be a few days. It turned into 2 years without my mother.
What did you think New York was going to be like? How did you imagine it?
I thought it was going to be like a castle, like, you know, white picket fence, like a fairy tale. And I got off the plane and it was cold. I remember the smell. I could always remember the smell when I got out of the airport, of the snow. And I had never seen snow. I remember the house. I remember that the furniture wasn't put down. The furniture was like piled up on each other, and I didn't understand why, because I thought it was gonna look like a big castle.
I'm proud of myself, but I'm proud of you guys. Thank you, girls.
You guys bust your time and time again. And sometimes I don't realize.
We're here. I'm here.
We love our Black Barbie.
Everybody comes up to me after we do things and say, good job, and you did it, and you did it, but we did it. We did it. We did a good job today. And I realize the sacrifices that you guys made. And I love you. Because you're my family. So when I yell and I scream, it's not that I don't like you, it's that I'm nervous. I don't want to fail. I have so many blessings, but the biggest blessing that I have right now in my life is my team. Anyways, that's it. Thank you.
Can you play crying game?
I didn't know that when I set out to make this album that it would entail an emotional roller coaster in my own real life.
Welcome to the crying game where you lose your soul. Where it ain't no easy pass, you gotta use the toll. Ain't no cruise control, you about to lose control. Ain't no smiling faces here, we slamming doors and dishes. Saying we don't miss each other, but it's all fictitious. Saying that we had enough, but enough of what? Another slap to the face, another uppercut. I'm just abusive by nature, not cause I hate ya.
I don't think I set out to make a more emotional album. It's just that I write my life
was in this long 11-year relationship and was proposed to, I always told him, you know what? Let's hold off. Let's hold off. No one could prepare for this business. Until you are in it, you really can't wrap your brain around it. You feel like this business changed people that I really loved. And it's like scary. It's scary. It's really scary. You know, they start worshiping material things and forgetting about just good old-fashioned love and trust and stuff like that. I guess that's why, you know, a lot of his songs are way more introspective, you know? Because I'm at a place now where I am stepping out of myself and looking at myself more. Brokenness leads to such beautiful art sometimes, you know? And I think I was really, really broken, like, writing this. The brokenness is okay as long as it can inspire people.
I know you're about to take over the world. I selfishly just don't
want
to be without you.
You see, your life, your childhood and everything reminds me so much of what I went through as a child. And no matter what you do, winning Idol has nothing to do with where your life is going to go. And I really love you.
I love you.
And the sun.
Thank you, guys. I just know that I'm so incredibly grateful and thankful for a couple little kids, maybe a few million. I call them my Barbs. And I know they're not in here today, but I know they'll hear me say this. Barbs, I love you so much for being by my side for such a long time. Billboard, thank you so much for recognizing me. And even before Super Bass, and even before Pink Friday, you believed in me even then. And I'm just really, really excited.
All of the women tonight that have been recognized, I am so proud of you for showing me that this can be done, that this is possible, and showing so many girls that you can be your own boss and that you can make music that you want and that you can project an image that you believe in. And I'm out of here. Peace.
Thank you. He came back after and said, you know, all the guys going to be on Motorsport. I was like, okay, yeah, I figured that. You know, I knew that much because I knew they were working on their group album. And he texted me and he said, is it okay to put Cardi on it? And I still have the text in my phone where I said, yeah, let's do it. And that's the only story I told. You know, I said exactly how it came about. And when it was time to clear the air about that, no one did that. You know, everybody... all of them allowed me to look like I lied. And, you know, even with the scheduling conflict, she's using my hairdresser now. So even he can attest to the fact, Tokyo, he knows that there really was a scheduling conflict and it was because of him. He's the one that couldn't show up. And I texted him. I said, you know that if I don't show up the day she's shooting, they're going to act like it's because I'm doing it to be mean. You know, with the current Nicki hate train. And he wasn't able to come. You know, he had something to do, and that's fine. So I had to shoot on another day. They all knew that, especially if you're using my hairdresser now. He can attest to that. And you still did interviews, and y'all all still jumped around that, and just to paint Nicki as the bad person so that you could play the victim. And that really, really hurt me because I really... fully supported her. And up until this recent interview that she did, I had never seen her show me genuine love in an interview. And I could just imagine how many girls wish they could have been on a song with Nicki Minaj. And I mean, I'm not saying it in a cocky way, but yikes.
I'm not saying that in a cocky way. I'm saying it like the first thing out of your mouth when someone asks you about a Nicki Minaj feature is, she changed her version of it. Excuse me? It's because of the Nicki hate parade that she felt the comfortability.
Don't ever in your life doubt yourself. Don't ever. Don't ever in your life.
You're going to make me cry.
Don't cry, please. Thank you for paying for my school. I'm going to stay in school for you.
Oh, God. I can't help it.
Please. No.
It's just that my fans are so special. And I fucking hate looking stupid and crying, but I don't give a fuck what they have to say about me. My fans are just so genuine. And I miss you guys so much. That's why I can't wait to come on tour and see you guys. And you're right, they don't want to show that side of me.
I just want to say humbly thank you. I'm able to attend school now. I come from where you come from, Queens.
Okay.
So our opportunities aren't always handed to us. Mm-hmm. So I just thank you for the opportunity. You keep on telling us, speak it, and it will happen. And that's part of my dream. And you helping me to see my dream is all I could ask for.
Aww.
So I really just thank you.
Oh, hold up. We're not done, Nicki.
Okay.
Where's Jason at?
I'm here on DACA, and so I don't get financial aid, and so I work hard, and my parents work hard to pay my tuition out of pocket, and you're really, like, lifting a heavy weight off of our shoulders by helping out, sis. Really, thank you. Thank you.
Man. Okay, listen, and that's just a testament to who she is as a person. Sometimes you just see people on a video or you see them in the movies because you know she's an actor too, or you're listening to their music, but you find out what's in the person's heart by the deeds that they do. And for Nicki doing that out of the kindness of her heart and being able to meet these people today, that's what makes her a queen, right?
I remember when my mother would let my father be violent with her. And she always brings up the story as a little girl. I would stand in front of my mother and go like this. Mm-hmm. And I vowed, like, that's why I'm, like, maybe some people would describe me as abrasive or bitchy or whatever, because I vowed from that age, no man would ever abuse me, call me out my name, treat me like that. And then all of a sudden, that was my life. Like, I let one human being make me so low that, like, I didn't even remember who I was. I was scared to get in the studio. Like, I didn't believe in myself. I didn't. All of a sudden, in Miami, I started catching a vibe as soon as I went to Miami. Like, as soon as I changed locations, mm-hmm. started catching the vibe. And then one day I got the vibe, it's time to go to New York. And you were there and you saw what was happening and it started being incredible. Coco Chanel,
sure.
Miami. Good form. All of those things just started as mumbles in the studio in New York.